Okay, so they said go ahead with further inspection, see what can be done. Okay, in this case, like slightly, and this microphone, 1 second. This one is like slightly baby a version of the Alienware. Okay, great. This one's gonna be tricky. Yeah, neural models, trackpad, the LED, keyboard all connect to this guy and from here to the motherboard. Trying to look for clues, you know. So this has become more like a MacBook. Little cover is on pretty much all connectors. Thank you. Damn, such a complex area. Why can't you keep it simple, Dell? Fans. Okay. I screwed this one up. No. All right, let's give it a quick cut. Cut it using this. So we just made a flat line, and then maybe we can reuse this guy to twist it. Okay, get a longer or a bigger one. Yeah, see that? Damn, okay. I think those two have to come out. So our solution should be right now visible, but we don't know what it is yet, okay. So 8 and 8, 16 gigs. What's hiding under here? Our beloved PCH, okay. Okay, so straight away let's target PCH. Three point something. Yeah, we have a dead short. And ground to ground on this cable. Oh, maybe fine. Three point five. I think they're short, mate. Okay, what does this coil tell us? That is low. Here to ground. Okay. Okay, so this is all behind the motherboard. Now let's bring the charger again. Okay, great. Put it in my pocket. It's on the floor again. Okay, let's have a look at the other side of that. Anywhere else of interest? Okay, let's have a quick look. A very tricky one. And then we go back to here. I think these look like the power rails. So use it. That doesn't mean he's faulty. Use at 33. See if the schematics for this board view, for this motherboard is available. We got schematics. Use at 33. Okay, 1, 2. Okay, so 1, 2 are there, which is voltage in, always on. Let's see what they say. 2 multimeters. If it shows 3.3 ohms, like what we read earlier on the PCH, that's game over. Yeah, 3.3 volts, reading 37 ohms, that's bad. Two, three, four, five. Four is always on. 5 volts. So 5 volt line looks good, and 8 and 7 are voltage out for the 3.3 volts, which is reading, yeah, not good. So I'm going to remove this chip and then measure it again. Just to rule out, maybe it's this chip, maybe not. Here to ground. That's nice. How about here? That's going up. Tricky one, isn't it? Now let's have a look at that PCH again. I think there we were getting 3.3 ohms. Yeah. Okay. Not good. So that there is 3 volt always online. What happens if we start putting some voltages there? probes. Voltage 1 volt, amp 1 amp, power on. Excuse me. Check ground connectivity. No, ground is not good. Okay, cabling is not good. Okay, ground was not good. Check the ground again. Okay, there we go. Nothing. Well, that is a good sign. That's great news. How about here? Here again. Good. Double check ground. Yeah, great. So this tells me a good thing that potentially, we're not sure yet, but potentially that guy is playing up. S29A. All right, nothing comes up for S29. No, it's 529A, okay. Says I've got, but let me check what the schematic says. G50. No, it's different. Okay, let's check G502. No, okay. So I have here a couple of Dell motherboards. We're looking for, how about W24K? Do I have W24K? No, okay. A961, another motherboard here. Okay, this have nothing. The 993. Nope. Maybe this guy should will have it, yeah. High chance. G341P. Damn it. I don't trust the schematics. Let me have another look. Gee, like spot on. That has similar design characteristics. What's UZ32 then? That's 5 volts here. Okay. Maybe we might find it. Keep looking. UZ30. Okay, so that SSD is CP power enable. Damn it. Yeah, then it's actually the other one. Shit. a voltage bias is different. It's 5 volts. I think it will be fine. Go back to use D32. Yeah. Because they use the same chip, exact same chip, one for the 5 volt, one for the 3 volt. Which to me says, SureCan, don't worry, be happy. So now, let's check the resistance again. It's going up, but still, you know. Okay, let's see what happens anyway. Bring the temperature sensor. Okay, so we're interested in this area. Okay. If it does play up again, then we know, you know, its issue relies with the PCH. Yeah, we're gonna find that area again heating up. Okay. Now let's have a look there. Cut the power. W equals two. I feel like I've got this chip. UT7. UT7. Okay, so we have voltage 1, 2, 3 in. So what that says, the second one, hopefully we're looking at the right one, that should be going to ground. No, this. No, second one is going to ground. Yep, so we got one being VCC. No, one is there. Yep. Wow, that's low. And that's no connect. No, it goes somewhere to resistor, 0 ohm resistor. Okay, 4 and 5. One of them is enable, one of them is, okay. This one to ground. Not sure. Could be 5, or this could be 5. Yeah, 3 volt line, there is a short. How about these diodes here? Okay. To ground. So that's connecting to a cap and then to number 5 or number 4. Yeah. So that means that's gonna be number 5. Yep. 5. No, there are short, that's enable pin. 3, ground, 1. Three volts. So this chip RT, I think I've got this one. RT 9069. Damn it, I've got RT 9058. Okay. How about in the other motherboard? It's available. Yeah. Telling me it should be that's it there. Okay. Yeah, but I do feel like we're actually chasing a rabbit, and most likely our PCH is damaged. That is very strange. Okay, I'll be damned. We're in a bit of a trouble. Two diodes started to disappear. Okay, found one. Found the other one. One second. Okay, we know where they go and how they go. So let's first fix up a problem here. That this guy is definitely, there's definitely some sort of a short here. It's highly unusual for this chip not to come out. Okay, now, let's try taking it out now. It's gone. I was preparing for some, like a fight, but it just came out. Okay. Put him over there. Okay, that's the replacement. Let's just manually put it on. Thank you. Can't tell which way is the right way. We're just looking for a line. It's gone. There he is. Is that the line? Because there is a line. Okay. Hoy. Okay, that's fine. Next one. I'll be damned. Okay, next one. Was more clear, okay. Right, okay. Damn it. Okay, it's fine. I know it's ugly. You can't see Jackal. Now I'm curious if there was another component there. Let me check the previous video. No, okay. Now I'm not expecting it to turn on or anything. But if it's the same behavior, then we know the chip is fine, because there's a fault on 3 volt line. It's giving us that heat. Okay. Same issue, because there's a fault on the 3 volt line. Which is sad. Yeah. Yeah, it's that chip. So what's that telling me, SureCan, that out LDOP is revolt. This guy has a fault. So why don't we, check some voltages. So we should have high voltage on one of the pins. Nineteen point nine three. And then four, which is enable. Five. 3.3. So it enables 3.3. That's good. And what will happen if we connect the charger or the battery? No, it won't charge battery. Three eight, okay. Okay, let's just check some random coils. No, nothing. Like 3 volt, 5 volt, they're not present. Yeah, I think PU600. PL600, okay. Oh, okay, that won't be it. Okay, how about PL401? Okay, that's 5 volts. 4.5, 2.4. It's partial. Damn it. Yeah, we have quite a high amount of heat being generated on this side. Okay, let's check that IC out. Three H equals 2, okay. PU 400. I think this could be the last chip that I will replace. I've got one. At location 432, I don't believe it, okay. Let me go get it. 432. Here it is. That looks bigger than his cousin. God damn it. It's a different size. You're a wanker. Okay. Then in that case, let's have a look at, what was the code? TPS 512. Okay, I still got it. I've got 7 of them. Oh, interesting. Yeah, got lots of brand new ones. Interesting, this one also have three equals two, so let me update my... Okay. 3H. What? I don't understand. Am I looking at the right schematics? Yes. Okay, then let me check the schematics for this guy. Let's have a look at pin number one. Looking at schematics, CS1, yep. VFB, VREG3, VFB2, CS2, EN2, PGOOD, SW2, VBA, yep, it's all correct. Wow. What a screw up by this company trying to screw us over. Okay, so 3H of that equals to this chip has to go this way. Okay, this is a really tricky job. Okay, okay, hang on a second. Okay, do it again. Alright, so I'm not expecting anything crazy or magic. Just want to see the voltage readings. Hey, that's healthy. No way. There's no bizarre reading. Either that is not working, not soldering them properly. Okay, so if we connect the battery, it should charge the battery. Okay. Fuck, it scared me. What was that? I don't know what any of that meant, but okay. Like, it could mean that the chip that we put in is crap, faulty, you know, fake, who knows. We're just gonna try putting it in the system. I wanna see if I get a light indicator in the front. That's my target. Keep it up. Hopefully nothing gets burned. Out of curiosity, what voltages do we have? So technically it's worse than before. Volts coming in. Yeah, that chip is either not good or not installed properly. Okay, I'll try another chip. I don't think it was installed properly, I think. Okay, let's put some solder. Okay. 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 All right, done. Connect the charger. This chip probably will get hot, indicating to us that, yeah, same behavior. So it's telling me 3-volt line somewhere down the track is shorted, which is most likely the PCH. And that means it's game over. Yeah, no change. I'll be happy with at least a light. It's behaving nicely there. It's just saying, SureCan, if you... Yeah, no. Okay, that's the end. We got a problem, Mr. PCH. See you in the next one. Thanks for watching.